Today, I will be giving a presentation on art in the Renaissance period. The Renaissance period came after the Middle Ages in Europe, which sparked interest in learning about the values of ancient Greece and Rome. To some, these sculptures and artwork are simply just paintings or pretty things to look at, but they are so much more than just creations. It, quote, captured the experience of the individual and the beauty and mystery of the natural world, quote, from history.com. Some of the most profound artists of this time were Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo. Together, creating hundreds of famous pieces of artwork, these artists helped shape the Renaissance time period. This is the Baptism of Christ, painted in 1472 Italy. When comparing Baptism of Christ and Florentine Pieta, at first the similarities are not obvious until you get a closer look. They both reflect the Christian religion. Leonardo da Vinci's painting shows Jesus Christ being baptized by St. John the Baptist, and Michelangelo's sculpture shows Mary and Nicodemus holding the lifeless body of Jesus Christ. Both of these are significant events in the Christian religion. Sculptures and paintings are two completely different mediums of art. Sculptures are 3D figures made out of marble or stone, usually, and are typically between 7 and 12 feet tall in height. You can touch it, walk around it, and see it from different angles. When contrasting to a painting, the differences are obvious. You can only view a painting from one angle, and it is on a canvas, usually no bigger than a TV. Sculptures are much easier to interact with and have more of a presence than paintings. Florentine Pieta was finished in 1553 Florence, Italy. It stands at 93 inches tall and is made of marble. Michelangelo worked on this for about 10 years intermittently. Quote, the Pieta was not a commissioned work and was believed to have been intended for his own tomb. Mary Magdalene, and Nicodemus, properly Joseph of Arimathea, support the crumpled figure of Christ. The statue was left unfinished after the leg of Christ had been broken off. A pupil and young friend, Tiberio Calgiani, attempted to complete the statue but died before he had done damage to the masterpiece. It is said that in the tender face of Joseph, one recognizes the features of Michelangelo himself. Quote, from MichelangeloExperience.com. For hundreds of years, cities around the world have attracted millions of people to their sculptures, such as Expansion in New York, Dramatic Fairy in the Ukraine, Colossus in Italy, Black Ghosts in Lithuania, Vesictitudes in West Indies, and many more. Having sculptures for the public eye makes visiting that place more enticing. For example, I've always wanted to visit Italy. I see the beautiful cities and have only dreamed of the food they have. But now I want to go there that much more so I can see Colossus. Additionally, sculptures speak to me on a spiritual level. I really can't explain how they make me feel. Maybe serenity? Sculptures are pieces of history and are constant reminders of the history around us. A painting becoming a sculpture would require one to take just the objects in a painting and make them 3D. For example, let's take the birth of Venus and pretend we want to turn it into a sculpture. We would have to leave out the ocean, the sky, the trees, and the land in the background to be able to successfully make a sculpture. We could sculpt Venus standing in the shell, We would also use the mermaid on the right-hand side of her and the angel and girl on the other side. A painting becoming a sculpture would be so much more lifelike and exciting to see. The baptism of Christ has so much iconography in it, or the, quote, interpretation of the content of images, according to Wikipedia. Across the world, many different versions of Christ, Mary, and other subjects have been spread. The most common version of Christ is Christ Pantocrator. In the East, numerous types of Mary have been developed with or without the infant Christ. More traditional models have come to for use in narrative paintings, including large cycles about the life of Christ. The iconography in the Baptism of Christ includes the cross, the Jordan River, the golden rays, and the dove. The cross represents God's love in sacrificing his own son for the sake of the human race. It also represents Jesus' victory over sin and death. The Jordan River is where the people of Israel crossed into the Promised Land and where Jesus Christ was baptized. The golden rays above his head in the painting represent God's love for his son. The dove is a, quote, symbol of peace originated with the early Christians, who portrayed the act of baptism accompanied by a dove holding an olive branch in its beak, quote, according to Wikipedia. Angels portrayed in early Christianity served the purpose of representing to humans the intentions of God. These were considered, quote, messengers or representatives of God, quote, taken from classroom.synonym.com. They were to communicate messages from God. Depictions of angels in Christianity have changed over time since the 14th century. Additionally, angels protect people, act in judgment, an example would be the angel of death, or can act as a guide. For thousands of years, many different religions have worshipped a divine being, but they also believe that it has an evil opposite. These creatures all have different names and different religions, but they all represent the same thing: anger, hatred, darkness, corruption, everything God stands against. To some, the belief that God has an opposite is necessary to keep the universe balanced. In Christian religion, Satan is a fallen angel. He rebelled against God and was kicked out of heaven for eternity. According to the Bible, his first victims were Adam and Eve, who he tempted with sexual pleasure. Quote, all humankind has the potential to be victorious over Satan, i.e., over their own passions that lead them astray. Quote, taken from Professor Mona off the National Geographic Channel. Originally from 14th century Florence, the Renaissance spread across Europe, passing on new ideas and ways of thinking. After the Black Death in Europe, many new people at the top of society looked to ancient Greek and Roman societies for inspiration on how to flaunt their wealth. Quote, Italy was flooded with lost classics from the ancient world, and artists such as Leonardo da Vinci, Botticelli, Michelangelo, Raphael, and Donatello, who took their tales, heroes, and gods as a starting point to creating an extraordinary art, quote, according to the Telegraph. However, Renaissance art did not just look pretty. It had new ideas on perspective, light and shadow were used more, and human anatomy was studied more closely. Additionally, Galileo and Copernicus had a new understanding of our planet's place in the universe. Gunpowder was becoming more widespread, while mathematics gave way to the new trading systems, making it easier to navigate across the world. Columbus discovered America, new continents were found, lands colonized, and new cultures were discovered, whose beliefs were added to the intellectual likes of Europeans. The printing press was also developed. Quote, the new ideas of free thinkers, mathematicians, and scientists all became accessible to the masses, and art and science became, for the first time in human history, truly democratic, quote, taken from the Telegraph. A lot of what we know today came from the Renaissance, from navigation to the discovery of the solar system, to the beautiful creation of Mona Lisa, to the intellect of Shakespeare, and new advances in math and science, man has achieved, quote, new heights in this tumultuous period, quote, from the Telegraph. The Renaissance period came after the Middle Ages in Europe, which sparked interest in learning about the values of ancient Greece and Rome. To some, these sculptures and artwork are simply just paintings or pretty things to look at. But they are so much more than just creations. It, quote, captured the experience of the individual and the beauty and mystery of the natural world, quote, from history.com. Some of the most profound artists of this time were Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo. Together, creating hundreds of famous pieces of artwork, these artists helped shape the Renaissance time period. Thank you for watching my video.